materials innovation company Ilika today unveils a new family of batteries set to revolutionize the design of sensors for the Internet of Things. To tell us more, we have Chief Executive Graeme Purdy with us today. Good morning, Graeme.
Hi.
Thank you very much for joining us. Now, today is the big launch of your Stereax solid-state battery technology. So, first of all, Stereax, what does it mean?
Yeah, actually, it comes from the Greek word stereas, which means solid, and it's a solid-state battery, so that's why we chose the word.
And what is it, a solid-state battery?
Well, a solid-state battery is a lithium-ion battery from which we have removed the liquid electrolyte and replaced it with a solid ceramic that allows the passage of lithium ions from one electrode to another.
And what are the key advantages?
The key advantages are that, first of all, they have a very low leakage current. So typically the leakage current is about a tenth of a normal lithium-ion battery, which makes it quite useful for capturing and storing energy from energy harvesters. The second advantage is that they're about half the size, so they generally have a very flat profile, which makes them easy to integrate with other electronics. And thirdly, actually, you can charge and discharge them very rapidly. So if you want to send a pulse of data across a wireless network and you need a pulse of energy to enable that, then solid-state batteries are very good for providing that short burst of power.
So would these batteries be used on their own or in combination with a means of recharging them?
Yes, they're designed actually to be recharged. So you can best combine them with something like an energy harvester, which typically would be a photovoltaic panel or a thermoelectric device or perhaps a vibration harvester, which would convert waste energy into an electric current.
So as long as you'd have a source of light, it would work?
That's right.
Forever? Yeah.
Indeed, interior lights or sunlight.
Okay. And tell us about your decision to target the Internet of Things market. Why?
Well, I think the Internet of Things market is very exciting for power supply technologies because ultimately most of the sensors that are currently connected to the Internet, and there are about 15 billion on the planet at the moment, are either hardwired or they're powered using disposable batteries. And so if you really want to unleash the creative design talents that are working on the Internet of Things and enable lots of new products, the big thing is actually to make that power source mobile so that you can deploy your sensors anywhere you want in different environments without having to worry about running a cable to them.
So the battery could have countless applications in many different fields, industrial, auto, medical.
That's absolutely right.
The world is your oyster, really, by the sound of it.
That's absolutely right. Just about every IoT application has a need for power in order to sustain the data stream back to your control system, back to the internet. And so any IoT application is a potential application for this battery technology.
And why can't standard lithium-ion batteries be used for the Internet of Things?
Yeah, the problem with standard lithium-ion batteries is that they actually have quite high leakage currents. And sometimes when you're using an energy harvester, you might only have milliamps or indeed microamps of current coming from that harvester. And if your battery is too leaky, it simply won't be able to capture those very small currents. Whereas if you have a perfect battery, then it will pick up those small currents, store it, and then have a store of energy that it can use to power the sensor when the energy isn't available from the environment. So, for instance, at nighttime when the sun goes down.
And there are other companies that have already produced solid-state batteries. So what's different about your solution?
Yeah, we use a new set of materials that have got a series of advantages in terms of the performance of the battery. And also we use a novel process for making the batteries, which means that actually we can make a larger capacity battery and also one that can be very easily encapsulated because actually some of the materials in some of the traditional solid-state batteries are quite reactive to air and moisture, and we've come up with a set of materials which are less sensitive to that environment and therefore are easily integrated into devices. And also, actually, we've come up with a set of materials that are more efficient at storing energy. So we have a 40% reduced footprint relative to the existing technology.
So apart from efficiency and environmental reasons, yeah, how do they compare cost-wise to standard batteries?
The price point at the size of battery that's required for IoT is comparable. So it's about the same.
And what is the business model you are going to adopt to monetize your technology?
Yes, we have a business model that's similar to the one that Arm Technologies has successfully used in the semiconductor sector. And that's a licensing model where we transfer our know-how to a large manufacturing company that produces these batteries at scale.
And talking about Arm Holdings, Charlene Marini, who's the vice president of the company, is quoted on your news release. So what's the nature of your relationship with Arm?
We have an informal relationship with Arm. Both companies are very interested in the IoT space. Obviously, Arm from a semiconductor perspective and Ilika from our energy source, our power source perspective. But actually, when you combine the technologies, you end up producing solutions that are of great interest to consumers and obviously the large companies that want to make the products that are sold to consumers.
Okay, so it sounds like you have a potentially very interesting product there. What's the roadmap to develop the product?
Yeah, so in fact, today we're launching our first battery in the family, which is our Stereax M250. The 250 denotes 250 micro amp hours of capacity, which is enough to power a perpetual beacon like this one, which is a temperature sensor. But going forward, there are a number of different applications, as you've just indicated. Some of them actually require even smaller batteries than the one that we have here. So this is about a square centimeter. There are some medical devices that need millimeter scale batteries, and actually solid state batteries are really good for that scale because they're easy to package, they've got a low profile, and you can integrate them into devices that you might apply to your skin as a patch or perhaps even ingest. So we have that miniaturization track. We also have what we call the capacity track, which is where we make a larger capacity battery on the same footprint. And in fact, the next product that we'll be launching is codenamed Beagle, and that will be available probably early next year. And then thirdly, we have a performance track, which is higher temperatures to allow you to deploy these devices maybe in motor vehicles or in process equipment, where the temperatures may be too high for a normal battery design. You have to make it a bit more robust to be able to deal with those higher temperatures.
Okay, Graeme, thank you very much, and best luck of all with your plans.
Thank you very much, Charlotte. It's been a pleasure.
Graeme Purdy, Chief Executive at Ilika.